There we go.
All right, we're rolling.
We like that?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Good.
I'm here today to speak the truth. The truth that we need Jesus in our lives. Jesus is coming soon, and we need to repent. Repent for your sin. Repent for your wrongdoing. And show forgiveness to your neighbor. The Lord Jesus will return soon. In Hebrews 9:27, it says, it is appointed unto man to die once, and after that receive judgment by the Lord Jesus. In the book of James, chapter 4, verse 14, you don't know what tomorrow brings. What is our life? Our life is nothing but a vapor. It comes, it goes, and we will be judged by God. Repent, repent. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. The end time signs are here. There's much evil in this world. What's bad is good, and what's good is bad. And we need to change our wicked ways. Jesus will be coming soon. The Bible speaks of what end times will be like, what signs we can expect. Let's open our ears. Let's open our ears and listen to the truth. We're here. We listen to garbage. We listen to trash talk. We listen to cursing, hurting our neighbors. This is not what the Lord wants. This is not what He gave us. He did not give us these types of motivations. He did not give us these types of morals. The Lord expects more from us. In the book of Revelation, in chapter 20, verse 15, it says, if anyone's name is not found in the book of life, he will be cast into the lake of fire. This is very real. The Bible's not a book. It's a book of prophecy. It's a book of science. It's a book of truth. And we need to accept the truth or deny the Lord. If you pick the second choice, if you deny the Lord, you will spend eternity in hellfire. The Bible speaks more of hell than it does of heaven. And this is for a reason. This is to warn us, to give us light, to give us truth. Because the truth is, Jesus is the only way to enter the kingdom of heaven. He is the only way to enter heaven. Without Jesus, we have no hope. Without Jesus, there is no truth. Without Jesus, there is no eternal life. The only eternal life that we will face without Jesus is hellfire. And this is the truth. I cannot lie to you. I wish I could sugarcoat it. I wish I could change the way it is. But the Word of God says if we reject Jesus, we will be subject to hellfire. Not just hell, hellfire. Okay? Jesus loves every single one of you. He loves all sinners. He loves everybody. It doesn't matter what you did. If you sincerely accept the Lord in your heart, He will forgive you for all your sin. It doesn't matter if you're a murderer. It doesn't matter if you're a thief. It doesn't matter if you're a liar. Because the Lord has the power to forgive. On that cross, He died. And He rose in 3 days, just as He promised. And thanks to Jesus, we get to have a second chance. Thanks to Jesus, we get to have eternal life. All we need to do is turn from our wicked ways and accept Jesus into our hearts. He can change a man like me. He can change anybody. I was the worst out of them all. I was stealing, I was robbing, I was selling drugs, I've done it all. I've been there, to crack houses, to heroin bags, but the Lord delivered me. The Lord saved me. The Lord can save you. All we need to do is reach our hand out to Jesus and ask Him and say, Jesus, come into my heart. Jesus, forgive me for my sins. And guess what the Lord's gonna say? Come with me, my child. Come with me. Take my hands. Follow my word, and the Lord Jesus will change you. He will change the way you speak. He'll change the way you act. He'll make you love your enemy, and you will do so with a willing heart. Stop holding grudges on everybody. Let it go. And you want to hear the truth. The truth is, if we can't accept and we can't forgive, if we can't forgive our neighbor, if we can't forgive our friends, if we can't forgive our enemies, how do you expect the Lord Jesus to forgive you? If we want forgiveness, we need to forgive our neighbor. We need to forgive our father that beat us when we were kids, because we're all human. We make mistakes. And the biggest liar of them all is the devil. The devil will take the most ugly thing and put it on a gold platter. He'll give you a beautiful song. He'll make it sound so good. But the truth is, it's poison. It's poison to our ears. The music we listen to is poison. Look at the lyrics next time to that song you're listening to. Look at the lyrics. Go online and check it out. I guarantee you it's going to be talking about robbing. I guarantee you it's going to be talking about adultery, about sleeping with your friend's wife, about cursing your neighbor, about F these people. It's me. It's me. It's me. No, it's not. It's not about you. We need to stop being so selfish. We can't be selfish. We have to share the truth. We have to be good. We have to give the word of the Lord with our neighbors. For me to sit here today and walk home and pack this in would be selfish, because I need to share the truth with each and every one of you. The truth that Jesus Christ died on that cross and rose in 3 days. Jesus died for you. He died for your sins. And all you have to do is extend your hand and accept Jesus into your heart. And when you do that, He will transform your life. He will give you hope. He will give you forgiveness. He will give you love, real love. Love and caring for one another. We need to stop this. We need to stop our wicked ways. We need to change and love each other, truly love each other, and spread the word of Jesus Christ. Without Jesus Christ, this world would be chaotic. If there was no God, this world would have no order. The world's bad enough, but imagine if this world had no order. God gives us life in our lungs. He gives us breath in our lungs. And if it wasn't for the Lord, we wouldn't be here today. We need to give thanks to the Lord. And we need to give Him the praise and Him the glory. If you're a good musical artist, it's not you that's good. The Lord gave you that talent. God gave you that talent. You should acknowledge God and give Him the glory. Give Him the thanks. Okay? If you're good at doing at what you do and your business is successful, when you have a successful business, you need to give the Lord the praise. It's not about you. We're all human. We are all going to perish. It's appointed unto man to die once, and then after that is the judgment. You're appointed to meet the Lord after we die. And if you deny the Lord, you're doomed for the lake of fire, for hellfire. We need to repent. Repent. Jesus is coming soon. He's giving us plenty of signs. He's given us lots of prophecy, predictions in the Bible of what is going to pass, what is going to happen. And I promise you, everything that the Bible said was going to happen, happened. It's not a book of fairy tales. I was in the streets a few months ago. I thought the same thing, but someone showed me. I read that Bible, and I found out the Bible is not fairy tales. The Bible is truth. It's prediction. It's prophecy. It's science. Everything the Bible said has come true. I promise you, I'm not lying to you. Repent. Repent for your sins and accept Jesus into your hearts. I promise you, this is the truth. I'm crying out to you today. Read the Bible. Read the Bible. Check on YouTube. Check on Google. And ask Google, what does the Bible say? What are the facts of the Bible? What predictions has the Bible made that have come true? And I promise you, you'll get a list. The devil doesn't want you to know the truth. The devil's hiding the word of God under a pillow. The devil's hiding the word of God under a blanket, under your bed. Pick up the word and read, and you will be changed. The Lord Jesus will change your heart. He will give you a heart of stone to a heart of flesh. Come today. Come step up. The Lord's reaching out to you. He wants you. You are his children. You are his children. And like sheep, we are being led astray. We are being led astray by the government. We are being led astray by those we call famous, by those celebrities. These guys are worshiping the devil, and they're putting it onto us. They're spreading this poison to our children. A world of cussing, a world of blasting your neighbor, of money, money, money. It's about me. This is lies. These are lies from the devil. And if we live in a lifestyle as similar to this without Jesus in our lives, we will enter hellfire. And I preach you the truth today. I preach you the truth that without Jesus, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Without repenting for our sins, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Go on YouTube. Go on YouTube and type in people that died and went to heaven and hell. And you're going to see for yourself thousands of stories. Thousands. The news, they don't want you to know this. Your celebrities, they don't want you to know this. Go on YouTube. Type in people that died and went to heaven and hell. And all you're going to see is people talking about their experience of hell with torment and fire and torture. And they're going to tell you the best experience they've ever had. Heaven with Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. You will not go on YouTube and you will not find any story talking about Muhammad. You will not find any story talking about Buddha, talking about Gandhi, talking about Mother Teresa. You're going to hear Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Without him, we will perish. Without Jesus, we will enter hellfire. I tell you the truth today. This is not me that's come here. The Lord commands it. He wants the truth to be heard. And we need to hear the truth. Without Jesus, we are doomed. We need to repent for our sins. Jesus is coming soon. The signs are countless. The Bible says in the end times, the signs will be overwhelming. And I tell you today, the signs are overwhelming. They're overwhelming the inside. Because the Bible's true. And a couple months ago, you could have asked me the same question. And I wouldn't have known because I didn't pick up that Bible. I didn't take that advice that my elders gave me. That my friends that believed in Christ gave me. I didn't take that advice. So I was living a blind life, thinking I'm a good person, I believe in Jesus, I'm gonna make it to heaven, I'm gonna do whatever I want. No! You need to repent and accept Jesus into your heart. Repent, because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The kingdom of heaven is close, it's in our grasp, and we're all gonna die. We have to come with the fact we are all going to perish. And without Jesus Christ, without the word of God, it is not possible to enter the kingdom of heaven without Jesus. I'm going to give you the end time signs. What the Bible says the world will look like. What the Bible says how we will act in the end times. Because without Jesus, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. Without repentance, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. We need to change our wicked ways, change the way we act. We need to change the stuff we listen to. The garbage that's on TV, it's ran by satanic worshipers. These people do not care about you. They don't care about your soul. They don't care about your kids. They're polluting your kids' ears with garbage, with cussing, with profanity. This is horrible. This is not what God wants. He wants the children to be taken care of. He wants the children to be raised right. We are confusing our youth. We are confusing the children. We need to put an end to this and get on our knees and pray to the Lord Jesus Christ to forgive us for our sins and forgive us for everything we've done. And through him, you can enter the kingdom of heaven. Through him, you can have eternal life. The Bible says in the end times, many will come claiming, "I am the Messiah," and he will deceive many. How many false religions are out there today? How many people came after Jesus Christ and tried to do what he did? And how many people succeeded? And I'll give you the answer, none. Nobody's done the miracles Jesus did. Jesus made the blind see. Jesus made the sick well. Jesus did what he promised. He rose off that cross. He died and he rose in 3 days, just as Jesus promised. And without the salvation of Jesus Christ, we will not enter the kingdom of heaven. The Bible says in Matthew chapter 24, verse 6, you will hear of wars and rumors of war. But see to it that you are not alarmed. Such things must happen. The Bible warns us, we're going to hear of wars and rumors of war. Do we hear rumors of war right now? You're right, we do. In chapter 7, it says nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be famines and earthquakes. The Bible speaking of the famines and the earthquakes that's going on in this world right now. Go on Google and type in, how many earthquakes and natural disasters have we had this year? We're at an all-time high, folks. We're at an all-time high for natural disasters. The Bible specifically says that in the end, there will be famines and great earthquakes. Great earthquakes. The Bible didn't just say earthquakes. The Bible said great earthquakes. Because these great earthquakes are reaching a massive peak. These earthquakes in 2018 are higher than they ever been, are more consistent than they ever been. Just like the Bible promises. And the Bible says these are the beginnings of the birth pains. And we need to accept Jesus into our hearts. Accept Jesus into your heart and ask him to forgive your sins. And we can enter the kingdom of heaven. The Bible says all children are innocent. They are innocent as can be. All children are children of the Lord God. But us as grown-ups, we are not children anymore. We have decisions we have to make. And we have to make the right decisions for our children, to be an example to the children. We need to be lights for these children so they grow up and they know right from wrong. The Bible says in the end times, bad will be good and good will be bad. And I tell you what, folks, it is that way right now. I can bring up 20 topics of evil. God is good.
All the time.
All the time. All the time, God is good. Jesus is the answer. We need to repent and accept Jesus into our hearts. And when we do this, Jesus will transform the way you think. He'll transform the way you act. He'll transform the way you talk. He'll give you those morals that we were given. We are losing our morals. We are losing our children. To poison. This industry is poisoning our children's ears. What's good is bad and what's bad is good. This is crazy. Wake up. Jesus is coming soon. The Bible gives us the signs of the end times. Men will be lovers of self. Men will depart from the faith. They will give in to doctrines of the devil. Now I tell you what, you might say, oh, I don't listen to doctrines of the devil. But next time you listen to that song on the radio, next time your children are listening to one of these rappers, take the lyrics, go on the internet and look at what they're saying. They will be using lots of profanity, lots of cursing against your neighbor, hate, greed, jealousy, talking about money, 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 money. Money is the root of all evil. But the devil's even bigger than money. The devil's what gives us these little treats that we think are good, but really they're poison. If I give you a glass of water today, and I take one drop of poison, and I put it in that water. Are you going to want to drink that water?
Stands out here and preaches that night, Saturday night.
No, I don't.
That's the way God looks at sin.
No, it's the first time we were here.
It's funny because we call this Preacher's Corner. We always come here like every Saturday night.
Is that right? Wow. Well, that's where God led us today. We wanted to go to Lake Eola, and we ended up over here. He's from Orlando. Yeah, I'm from Haines City.
Okay, that's Jesus over by me. I'm in Winter Haven.
Yeah, Winter Haven, yeah.
And without Jesus, wow. It's like going to
but
court.
I come here every weekend, and my brother lives here.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Paul. Nice to meet you. Yeah, that's my son, John.
And you got red handy with no oil. What's going to happen?
Great.
Amen.
If you come here late at night, you'll see Bart. He has kind of the same setup.
Yeah.
He's got a floor speaker.
Okay.
It's like a horn now. So
is that right? Wow. How do you like that? Well, that's where God led us today.
Yeah, we were down. Yeah. That's kind of fall festival.
Yeah. 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 That's why we were going to go. And then we saw that. And then we were looking around. And he said, let's set up here.
Yeah. They'll shut that down. Yeah. That's what they did to us. We started on the bullhorn.
Yeah. Yeah. Again,
yeah, he was. They shut him down last week over there. But then the cops said,
He's gonna have
that
his
night,
people.
Like Saturday night, they'll even but come right here. They'll close that down.
Yeah,
they'll close that street down. Close this down.
Yeah.
So they'll sit like this. The cop cars will be like this.
Yeah.
And we're just preaching.
Is that right?
Yes, we do.
Wow. That's awesome. Yeah, awesome.
Nobody really gives us any trouble because there's cops.
As a child.
Wow, that's awesome.
And God gives us this free will to see what we are going to do with that free will.
Right.
Because God is a fair God. God is just. And Jesus is so fair and just. He gave us this Bible. He gave us the Bible to show us proof. He gave us his prophecies, his predictions. All the predictions in the Bible, about 1,000, have came true. The only ones that haven't come yet are the ones after Jesus' return. So all we're waiting on now is Jesus' return. And now is the time. Now is the time to turn from our sin. Now is the time to reach out our hand and ask Jesus into our hearts and repent. Repent.
Okay, nice
because
feedback.
The kingdom of heaven is at hand.
God bless you.
The times are countless. The times are coming. Thank you. The time is now. Today is the day. Today is the day to turn from our sin. To say no to that poison. And accept Jesus into our hearts. Jesus is a loving God. He cares for each and every one of you. Yeah, we're all sinners. I'm a sinner. I'm the biggest of them all. But I extended my hand out and I asked Jesus Christ to forgive me of my sin and repent. And Jesus will extend his hand back and he will pull you in and he will show you the love that he promised. He will show you what the Holy Spirit can do. I experienced this Holy Spirit. I experienced God touch me. God touched my heart. He gave me a heart of stone to a heart of flesh. I used to be in the streets. I didn't care. If you want to get robbed, I'll rob you. If you want to go sell whatever you want to sell, let's do it. I'm for it. But Jesus changed me. 28 years of my life, I lived blindly. And one day, God took the veil off my eyes. He took the blindfold off my eyes. And he showed me. He showed me the truth. And the truth is, the Bible is no joke. The Bible is 100% true. Jesus came on this earth, God in the flesh. And he died for our sins, for our transgressions, for what we did. Jesus was sinless. He died for us. And he prophesied this. He prophesied he would be risen in 3 days. He would rise. And Jesus rose from the dead. And after 3 days, he came back. And he showed the apostles. He showed his followers the truth. What Jesus says is true. He always says in the Bible, I tell you the truth. Repent. Repent because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. I promise you, I'm crying out to you today. Leave this life of sin and accept Jesus into your hearts. We need to turn from our sin. The Bible gives us plenty of prophecy. The Bible gives us scientific facts. The Bible stated 3,000 years ago that the earth was round, that the earth was free-floating on top of nothing. Now, let me tell you something. If this is God's book, God is not a liar. So God will not have something published that is false. God will not give you something that is not true. So when you pick up that Bible, and the Bible says, this and this and this is going to happen, I promise you that it happens. And anything that hasn't happened yet is after the return of Jesus. These prophecies are true. The Bible has about 1,000 prophecies. And through these prophecies, God is validating himself. You say, show me the proof. You tell me, show me the proof. I have the proof right here. Come look. I'm begging you today. Give up your sin. I have proof. The Bible says you will have eyes, but you can't hear. I mean, you can't see. You will have ears that you can't hear. You will have a mouth, but you can't speak. Because we are blind. We are deaf. We are mute. We have the answers right in front of us. We have them here today. Come get prayer. Come accept Jesus into your life and start a new life. The Bible says it's appointed unto man to die once and then face judgment upon the Lord. The Lord is going to judge us when we die.
Hey, nice to meet you, I'm Paul.
The Bible also says,
if you guys got this hand, we'll bring it
down. Our life is nothing but a vapor.
Let me ask, maybe he wants to break it, you guys can take over.
If you don't know Jesus, if you reject Jesus, how can you expect him to accept you?
As they walk past us, as we preach him, they'll come and get hit by
this all right. Hey, if you see anybody, I have peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, cookies, and water here. Okay. If you see anybody needs any food, I have food here, okay?
Jesus does not send anybody to hell. We send ourselves. We are given a choice.
All right, brother.
We're given a choice.
Okay.
We are given free will.
You want something to eat, brother?
Okay, I'm good.
Jesus
Maybe later. I'm going to be here all night.
All right.
I'm a volunteer. My name is Nelson.
I'm Paul. Nice to meet you.
What we're going
to
do with that free will.
We're going to have the beers real quick back there.
All right, if you want any peanut butter and jelly or anything.
There's a couple of homeless people, but you really can't pass out.
Of this earth.
There you go.
Of this universe.
You want that in there?
The creator. If we reject the word, the world is going to reject you on judgment day. Repent, because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Accept Jesus in your hearts today and turn from your sin. Turn from a life of sin and accept the Lord Jesus in your heart. He will transform you. Ask this young brother right here. He knows me. And Jesus changed my life. Jesus changed my life. He gave me a heart of stone to a heart of flesh, just as he promises. The Bible has so many predictions. So many predictions, and they all come true. But we decide to look the other way. We decide to reject the world. We decide to bury our face in our phones and our social media instead of really looking at the truth. If I told you, I'm going to give you a plan to make $1 million, and I gave you directions, why wouldn't you follow those directions? Most people would. But as soon as we hear the word God, we run, because we don't want to give up our sin. We don't want to accept Jesus. The Bible says, in the beginning was the Word, Jesus Christ. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. And in chapter 1, verse 14, it says, and the Word became flesh. Now the Word of God became flesh. The Word of God came to this earth, and the Word of God died on that cross, and he rose in 3 days for our sins. We have several prophecies in the Old Testament describing Jesus 1,000 years before Jesus was even born. It says he will be pierced. His hands and feet will be pierced. He will be whipped for our transgressions. Through his stripes, through his pain, we are healed. Accept Jesus today and turn from your sin and get a new life, because Jesus will give you that life. Jesus will show you the truth. He'll show you the way, and he'll show you the meaning of this life. And the Bible says, what is our life? Our life is nothing but a vapor. It comes and it goes, and then we're appointed to meet God for judgment. The Lord Jesus is going to judge us. Are you ready for judgment day today? You might take your last breath tonight. You might take your last breath tonight. We don't know. We don't control our lives like that. Tonight we might go to sleep and not wake up. But what's going to happen when you die without having God? What's going to happen if you die without having Jesus in your life? Without having Jesus in your heart? You're going to regret it. The Bible talks more about hell than it does of heaven. But the good news is Jesus loves you. And today you can turn from your sins. And today is the day for salvation. Through the blood of Jesus Christ, he came on this earth. And he died on that cross, and he rose in 3 days for your sins. And in the name of Jesus, I rebuke any evil dwelling in this place, stopping everybody from coming to the Lord. The Lord has his arm stretched out today, and he says, come home. Come to me. I will bring you peace. I will give you what you want. But first, you need to repent for your sins. And once you do that, you can accept Jesus into your heart. It's the most important thing we'll ever know, that without Jesus, without repentance, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. We need Jesus in our hearts, and we need to deny ourselves and pick up that cross and accept Jesus. He loves you. Jesus cares about you. He knows how many hairs are on your head. The Bible tells us this. The Bible gives us certain predictions, certain prophecies, over 1,000 predictions. And all the predictions up to this time frame that came true, predictions are still coming to pass to this day. I promise you, I thought the Bible was a fairy tale too, until I read it, until the Bible started making all these predictions. The Bible told me.
Hey, brother.
The Bible gave me the proof that I needed. I needed the proof. And the Bible gave it to me. Go on YouTube. Go on Google. And type in facts of the Bible.
I met a guy on the street.
Oh, cool, cool.
There you go.
And I gave you cookies.
You jaw will drop how many predictions the Bible has.
I'll give you
a thousand predictions.
All right, you got that.
God
bless you.
And all the predictions have come true. There's only certain left, and those are all after the second coming of Jesus. Jesus is trying to talk to you today. He's letting you know that if you deny the Lord, you will spend eternity in hellfire. The devil is not your friend. It's not cool to say anything. Hail Satan, whatever you want to say. You think you're cool. You want to listen to this garbage music from the devil himself. But the truth is, the devil is not your friend. The devil might give you what you think you have, but everything you have will perish with this earth without the blood of Jesus. If Jesus didn't die and rose in 3 days, we would be in big trouble. We would have to question ourselves. But we don't have to question ourselves today. Today we can accept Jesus into our hearts and turn from a life of sin and pick up a Bible. Pick up your neighbor. Help them out. Be encouraging to everybody. Jesus had 2 laws. Love the Lord thy God with all your heart and love your neighbor as yourself. If you can't forgive your father that beat you, if you can't forgive your brother, if you can't forgive an enemy, the Lord is going to hold you accountable on Judgment Day. The Lord will hold you accountable on Judgment Day. He's going to ask you, I forgave you for your sins. Why couldn't you forgive your brother? Why couldn't you forgive that man? Jesus forgives us all, but we need to repent. We need to ask Him to forgive us for our sins and turn from those sins. The Bible tells us many things. It gives us useful information. We think to go on Google for information, when the Bible had all the information in our face the whole time. A few hundred years ago, hundreds of years ago, people were wondering, is the earth circular or is the earth flat? If they just picked up a Bible and read it, they would have known. The Bible says the earth is circular and it's free-floating upon nothing. This Bible was written 3,000 years ago, before we had satellite camera, before we had any technology. The Bible stated as a fact, the earth is round and the earth is free-floating upon nothing. The Bible 3,000 years ago spoke about quarantine, to quarantine the sick. It gives us specific directions, but nobody listened. And what happens when we don't listen to God? We pay the price. So people were getting the plague in Europe. Millions of people died because they did not quarantine. The Bible is nothing but truth. The Bible says the life is in the blood. If we do a blood test today, what does it tell us? It tells us the health that we have. It tells us our blood type. It tells us where we came from. It's our DNA. And the Bible 3,000 years ago spoke about this. The Bible gave us the answers before we had proof of them. But nobody listened to the Bible. So the consequences had to be paid. If you deny Jesus today, and you die tonight, you will be in danger of hellfire. But Jesus loves you so much. He died on that cross in your place. He died for your sins, so that you might be forgiven, so you might inherit the kingdom of God. The Lord has a mansion waiting for each and every one of you. The Lord will reward you. But you need to humble yourself on this earth. The Bible says it's appointed unto man to die once and then to face judgment upon God. God is going to judge us. And we need Jesus in our lives, because without Jesus, we're going to be judged without a lawyer. We're going to be by ourselves on that stand. And we're going to be found guilty. We're all guilty of sin. We're all sinners. I'm the biggest sinner of them all. I've sinned for 28 years. But one day, I reached my hand out to Jesus, and He changed my life. He touched my heart with the Holy Spirit. When the Holy Spirit touches you, there's no mistaking it. When God touches your heart, there's no mistaking it. It's like getting a hug from the Father that you thought was dead. But Jesus is not dead, He's alive. And He loves every single one of you. No matter what your sins are, Jesus can forgive them. Jesus can give you eternal life in heaven. But if we deny the Lord and we die tonight,
hungry,
we should so
you're
take
hungry?
Our last breath
you
tonight.
You want
we
a
will be in danger of hellfire.
I got water.
And I don't like to preach on hell, but I have to
cookie?
Tell you the
you
truth. I have to tell you the truth. And the truth is, without Jesus, we will not inherit the kingdom of heaven.
I'm trying to reach Jesus.
We will not inherit
Jesus?
The kingdom of heaven without
well,
Jesus.
I know Jesus.
We need to repent and be forgiven.
Alright. You
come
want me to pray for you?
Accept Jesus in your heart.
Yeah. What's your name?
Come change your life today.
Jerry? Hi Jerry,
Jesus.
I'm Paul.
You died
pleased to meet
3 days on that cross for our sins.
Yeah.
For our sins.
So let me
I'm not a perfect person.
Huh?
I'm not a holy man. But Jesus changed
no,
my life.
No, I got food
Jesus
if you want food though.
Righteousness.
It's free.
That's okay.
Yeah?
I've done them all. I've done every sin. I've done every single drug.
I got
and I was proud
I got
of
pe-
it.
I don't need you food.
I was
want
proud
it?
Of
I got
being
peanut
a drug
butter
addict.
And jelly.
I was
no?
proud of being
water?
A drug dealer.
You want a water?
No? I was proud of my car.
Okay.
Thank you, brother.
God I was proud of driving a Maserati.
Let me pray.
God bless you.
Yeah, amen. Let me pray for you, Jerry.
Man,
come
but
here.
Jesus Christ.
Father, I pray for my brother
Jesus
Jerry,
Christ.
Lord God, that... Lord, he
Jesus
said he's saved.
Christ.
He knows you, Lord.
Jesus
I just pray you take care
Christ.
Of Jerry, Lord God,
Jesus
that you would watch
Christ
over him, make a straight path for him, show him where to go, Lord God. Take care of my brother, Lord God.
You
we pray thanking you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen.
20 topics of bad, and I promise you I'll have a line out the door trying to debate me on those 20 evil topics. The Bible teaches us morals. It teaches us right from wrong. But without Jesus in our hearts, we need to repent. We need to repent and accept Jesus in our hearts. He'll take a man like me out the street. He'll take me off the drugs. He'll take me off the corner. He'll take me from hate in my heart and robbery to on my knees asking the Lord to forgive me. Because the Lord Jesus has the power through the Holy Spirit. And when the Holy Spirit touches your heart, there's no mistaking it. When the Holy Spirit touches you, there's no way you'll look out away again. Because the Holy Spirit will fill you with joy. It'll fill you with hope. It'll repair your broken heart. Everybody acts like their hearts aren't broken. Everybody acts like they're so happy. But without Jesus in your heart, you will never be whole. Without Jesus in your heart, you will never enter the kingdom of heaven. The Bible says in the end times, many will turn away from their faith and betray and hate each other. And they will appear and deceive many. We have many false faiths these days. We follow doctrines of the devil. We follow music from the demonic forces themselves. We follow these false religions. But where's the proof? You ask me for proof, I got a whole book of proof. Prove the Bible wrong. It will not be done. The Bible made 1,000 predictions. And guess what? Those 1,000 predictions are true. Those 1,000 predictions cannot be disproven. Because the Lord Jesus is God of this world, God of this universe, God of the heavens and earth. And do you think that the God of the heavens and the earth would make false predictions? No. If you are following a religion today, and one of your prophets said something was going to happen, but it didn't, he's a false prophet. If your prophet said that this and this and this was going to happen, but it didn't happen, let me tell you, that's a false prophet. Don't believe a liar. The only one we can trust is Jesus Christ. He's nothing but truth. He's reaching out to you today. He's reaching out to you. He sends his people because he wants you to hear the word of God. He wants you to hear the truth. You might think God's never sent me a sign. God's never shown himself. But let me ask you something. Have you reached out to Jesus Christ? God speaks to you all the time. When you go to the hotel room, you find a Bible in your drawer. When you hit that corner, you might see someone preaching the word of God. This is God reaching out to you today to change your life. Jesus loves everybody. Jesus loves us all, but we have to accept him to be accepted. If we don't accept Jesus and turn from our sin, the Lord's going to say, depart from me, you worker of iniquity. I never knew you. And let me tell you, if the Lord says that, you will be in great sorrow. You will be in grief. The Bible talks about hell. The Bible says that hell is weeping and gnashing of the teeth. Weeping and gnashing of the teeth. And regret and sorrow. Because you're going to remember, I heard about Jesus. I heard about this God. But I always turned my back to Jesus. I never reached out and I never truly tried to ask Jesus to forgive my sins. I never reached out and I never asked Jesus into my heart. The Bible says it is appointed unto man to die once and then to be judged by God. Now let me ask you something. If you were to die today, are you ready to receive judgment by the Lord Jesus? Are you ready to be judged by the Almighty God? If you don't have Jesus in your heart, I promise you, you're not ready to be judged by the Almighty. Without Jesus, we will not enter the kingdom of heaven. Without Jesus, there is no hope. But Jesus didn't just come here and say what he said. Jesus left us with prophecy. Jesus left us with promise, with proof. There's proof in the Bible. I thought there was no proof. A few months ago, I was in the streets. I was doing drugs. I was partying. I was sleeping with any woman I want. But guess what? I opened that Bible. I went on YouTube and I found out that the Bible is true. The Bible is nothing but truth. Come today and accept prayer. Come today and accept Jesus into your hearts. I give you that open invitation right now. Come. Come get prayer. Accept Jesus in your heart and turn from our wicked ways. And we will inherit the kingdom of heaven. Jesus loves every single one of you. Jesus loves everyone. For God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. This is what the Bible says. But do you truly believe in Jesus today? The Bible speaks about being lukewarm, one foot in and one foot out. And the Bible tells us what will happen to the lukewarm Christian. What will happen to the lukewarm in faith? The Lord says he will spit you right out. And why is that? Because you didn't pick a side. Now on judgment day, you better have your side picked. You better be with Jesus or you're going to be against him. But the Bible talks about all those who reject the Lord. The Bible speaks of those who reject the name of Jesus. They will be cast into the lake of fire. The Bible speaks of hellfire. And hellfire is no way pleasurable. The hellfire is no way a party. There is no water in hell. There is no rest in hell. There is no friend to have your back in hell. The only real friend you have here today is Jesus Christ. The only Savior. Jesus in your heart today, come receive prayer. Go home tonight and pray. Get on your knees and ask Jesus, Jesus, forgive me for my sins. Forgive me for my wrongdoing. Take the hate out of my heart. Help me love my enemies. Help me love those who have made fun of me. And the Lord will do that for you. Because we need to forgive everybody to be forgiven. If we want to ask Jesus into our hearts and ask him to forgive our sins, we need to forgive everybody around us. We can't be hypocrites. That's what you call a hypocrite. You want forgiveness. You want mercy. But you don't want to give it to those who ask. You don't even want to give it to those who are your enemies. And I understand that's the human flesh in us. But the Lord Jesus will change you. He'll give you a heart of stone to a heart of flesh. And you will learn to love everybody. I love everybody. And that's because Jesus gave me that heart. Jesus gave me what I have. The power to forgive my enemies. The power to humble myself and get on my knees. We need to repent. Repent for our sins. Repent and accept Jesus. Turn from our wicked ways. The Bible says it's appointed unto every man to die once and then face judgment. The Bible says, what is life? Life is nothing but a vapor. It comes, it goes, and we will meet God. We will meet God after this life. Go on YouTube, type in people who have died for 1 hour, people who have died for 2 hours, 3 hours, 3 days, and they all went to either heaven or hell. There is no purgatory. There is no hanging out. There is no in the dirt. You don't just disappear. The Lord Jesus tells us in the Bible what happens. And we have a choice. We can accept Jesus into our hearts or we can deny him. But I tell you, the best decision I ever made was accepting Jesus in my heart. This is an open invitation to everybody. Everybody's welcome to accept Jesus into your heart. He doesn't discriminate. But we need to turn from our sin. We need to change our life. And Jesus gives us the power to change life. We need to repent because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Just like John the Baptist said, he said, repent, because the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And I tell you today, the signs the Bible gives us are here. The prophecies have been fulfilled. The predictions have came true. I was like everybody else. I didn't think so either. But guess what? I found out. I did my research. I went on Google and I typed in Google. What facts of the Bible have came true so far? What prophecies and predictions have came true? You're going to get a list. You're going to get a list so long, it's going to take you the whole day to read all those predictions. All the predictions the Bible made have came true, except the ones that are after Jesus. And Jesus is coming soon. The Bible gives us the signs of the end times. The Bible says, know this, in the end times. In 2 Peter chapter 3, the Bible says, know this, that mockers will come in the last days, mocking, following their own sinful desires. They will say, where is the promise of Jesus? Okay? And it says, forever since, we will say, forever since our fathers have been dying, coming and going, the world's been the same. The world's been repeating itself. Where is this God? Where is this God? And I tell you today, God is here. God, Jesus Christ is here. And he's begging you. He's not begging you. He's asking you with an open heart. I'm begging you. I beg you. Come to the Lord Jesus. Repent for your sins. Because if you die without having Jesus in your heart, you will be subject to hellfire. To hellfire. This is no joke. You know how many people died and went to heaven and hell? Go on YouTube. Type it in. Type in YouTube. How many people died and went to heaven and hell? You're going to see a list of people and they're going to tell you their stories. They're going to tell you the story of what happened to them. They're going to tell you that they went to heaven or hell and the only answer is Jesus Christ.
I got food.
Jesus is the only one that's going to have your back on Judgment Day. Jesus is the only one that's going to help you out when we die.
We're
going to be judged. And without Jesus in our hearts, we will be sent to hell. And it's not something I like to talk about. It's not something that's pleasurable to the ear, but it's the truth. The Bible says if you reject Jesus and you don't ask for repentance of your sin, you will be sent to hellfire. This is not fun. This is not a game. This is no joke. Go on YouTube, type in people that have died for days, 3 days, 3 hours. It doesn't matter. They died and they either went to heaven or they either went to hell. And every single person says the same thing. Jesus Christ is real, and they want to warn everybody. The government doesn't want you to hear this. The celebrities don't want you to hear this. They want you to keep living in sin by their music and do whatever they want to do. But I tell you the truth. Nobody understands that if you go on the internet and do the research, you will find the proof. If you open that Bible and you read it, you will find the proof that Jesus is for real. Jesus is the only way. He's the truth and he's the life. No one comes unto the Father in heaven except through Jesus Christ. Jesus gives me my strength. Jesus changed my heart. Jesus gives us all, everything that we need, but we don't even realize it. Is God not kind enough and he gives us heaven from the earth unto the earth? He gives us rain unto this earth. God provides. He gives us air to breathe, food to eat. He gives us children, our families. These are all blessings of the Lord. This is a little bit of a taste of heaven, but this is nowhere near heaven. This is the earth. This is downtown Orlando. We are not in purgatory. We are not in heaven. This is the earth. But after we die, we will be subject to judgment by the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, Jesus accepts everybody. Jesus can forgive you. All you have to do is ask for forgiveness with an open heart and truly ask, Jesus, forgive me for my sins. Come into my heart and change the way I think. Jesus, change me from sinning, please. And the Lord will change you. But we need to be sincere. We need to really ask the Lord, Lord, change my heart. I don't want to live in this sin no more, Lord. And I promise you, if you have your hand truly stretched out, the Lord will reach back and he will grab you and he will pull you in.
John, I'm going to get this guy some food.
Yeah.
Can you?
Yeah.
I could leave. You want me to leave it on? No.
Shut up.
I'll bring the cooler here. Okay.
Man. How much of sin you're in?
Man.
Come to the Lord today and ask
God
for repentance.
God bless
you. He extends his hand to every single person. He doesn't discriminate. He doesn't discriminate.
Thank you, Jerry.
It don't matter who you are or what you've been.
Thank you, brother.
You're doing what you're doing, brother.
I appreciate that, brother. Thank you for the encouraging words.
I'm an alcoholic. I can't get
it. Hey, bro. I've been there. You know, I've been there, too. I was a heroin addict. I was a crack addict.
Maybe.
Smoking heroin and crack together.
Maybe.
Yeah, bro. I was bad. But the Lord delivered me. He could deliver you.
I don't even say that.
Yeah, it happens, brother. It happens to all of us. But you know what? When you get home tonight, pray to the Lord. Pray to the Lord.
I don't have a home, man.
Oh, you don't have a home. All right, well, hey, tonight, pray to the Lord, brother. Pray to him and ask him, Lord.
I do it every day.
Awesome, yeah, bro. Good, I'm glad.
God bless God.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
God bless yes. Jesus.
God loves you,
because
Jerry.
You know what? Jesus Christ is the one who lives and died.
Yes.
For our sins.
For our sins. You're right.
That what were we messed up, man?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, that's it.
Yes.
Throw it away.
Uh-huh. Amen. Amen, brother.
That's why you tell the Lord, I know I'm a sinner,
Amen.
God, but
Amen.
Forgive me.
Amen.
Amen, brother.
Love you, Jerry.
Yeah,
we love you.
You, brother, for real.
I love you, man.
Thank you, brother.
You know, man, God bless
you. Yeah, bro, don't worry.
I'm not going to cry. I'm not
yeah.
You know, man.
Listen, you know, Jesus is our strength.
I have a dollar in my pocket. That'll make
no
difference.
No, don't.
Let me tell you something.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus is more important
than anything
in the world.
Amen.
The Bible says it's harder for a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven than it is for a camel to go through a needle.
That's
That's because when you have so much money, you can't focus on God. You don't want to accept Jesus, because when everybody has all this money, they're thinking about money, 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 or stuff and cars, and but Jesus is the most important thing. So a lot of people forget that God, Jesus Christ, is the most important. So I'm happy, brother, that you have Jesus, and I'm happy you're a believer.
Yes, amen, amen.
The Bible says whoever believes in him will not perish, but have everlasting life. Everlasting life.
Amen.
Through the blood of Jesus.
You know, I know the word.
You amen. Know the word, too.
Amen. So through
May
the blood
God
of Jesus.
Bless y'all.
Amen.
Y'all out here because you love the
yes.
Lord.
Yes. We love the Lord and we want to help people.
It's people, man. It's God.
Amen. Amen. That's true. It's God. God gives me the strength.
God Amen. And Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is the one who died on that
that's
cross.
That's right. Amen. That's
right. You know, a lot of people don't understand, man, yeah, yeah. when he died on that cross.
Yeah.
The pain and suffering.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, he went through a lot, man.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But God loves you, Jerry.
God loves you, and I'm glad
God
you
loves
believe.
You.
I do. Okay.
All right, brother. God love you.
I love
you. Awesome, brother. All right, God bless you. Just keep saying your prayers, and you'll
I'm
be good.
I'm not believing in that, man. I'll tell you something, man. I believe in God, and I believe in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And Jesus Christ is the one who's going to save the world.
Amen, brother.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, he will.
Amen.
Amen, brother. Have a blessed day. I don't know, maybe I knew that guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, what
how's
up,
you going, man?
How's
my name's Robert, man.
You're Robert?
Yeah,
I'm John.
I'm Robert.
Where do you go to church around?
I go off of, you know where Kirkman Road is?
Kirkman Road? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
yeah, yeah. Off of Kirkman Road or Raleigh Street is the church house name, Southside
yeah.
Church of Christ. That's where I go.
I just started getting into the street preaching. I've been doing YouTube videos too.
Yeah.
Like
we have
sermons.
A YouTube channel too.
Yeah. Can I get your number?
Yeah,
we can link up.
I want to talk to you anyway.
Okay, awesome, bro.
Who is that? Sean was here, right?
Yeah, Sean was here.
He was telling us this is called the Preacher's Corner. We didn't even know it.
Well, we call it the Preacher's Corner because a brother of ours named Bart comes here.
Yeah.
Some other guys come here too as well.
Yeah.
We don't really talk to the other guys like that, but we don't really know them like that.
Yeah.
But we come here almost every Saturday.
Yeah.
And Bart comes here all the time
Amen.
Too. So it's an anointing on this block.
Amen. Well, we were going to Lake Eola. He got kicked out by the cops the
you
other
did?
Day.
Yeah. I almost
did. Yeah. But today we went back. And then we didn't know that there was this festival going on, whatever. So he was looking around, and he says to me, just park here. We're going to come to this corner.
Which day did you get kicked out?
I got a week ago.
A week ago?
Yeah, a week ago today.
I got kicked out at the Pride Parade.
Oh, you did?
They had to escort me out, like 12 police. I was like, it's not necessary.
Really?
I'm like, I'm not going to do violence or anything. Like, but they kicked me out, and I had to do something last week, so we didn't come out. But, yeah, they like you only
when did they have the Pride Parade?
2 weeks ago.
Oh, 2 weeks ago?
Yeah.
And what's going on over here today?
That's the Fall Festival.
Oh, the Fall Festival.
That's where I was just at. I was preaching over there, and they tried to kick me out again, but I told them, I was like, listen, I'll be cooperative. I'm not going to use the bullhorn. I'm going to just use my regular voice.
Yeah.
I started out just using my regular voice, so I said, it's no problem.
Yeah.
So I put it down, and I just started preaching my regular voice, and they couldn't do anything about it.
Yeah, you can't do nothing.
Yeah, so after that,